I work in the area of integrated circuit manufacturing design and test. So when integrated circuits are fabricated, they're typically fabricated in a very complex foundry or fab, as we call them. Now, unfortunately, when we fabricate these circuits, they don't always work. There's a yield that can range from 10 to 80%, meaning that 90% of 100 parts that you fabricate don't work. I do research in the area of how you detect these defects in these chips. Now, one of the important issues with fabricating these chips is that most are actually fabricated overseas. So one of the things that is of great importance is how do you fabricate chips without actually giving away your intellectual property? So there's a need to actually design a chip in such a way that one looking at it or reverse engineering it doesn't understand how it operates. And that's something my students and I work on. We work on how to design obfuscation into a design. So whether it's stolen, reverse engineered, analyzed in some way, that adversary cannot understand how it operates. So the approach my students use to obfuscate designs is called cryptologic. We actually take a design and we encrypt it just like you would encrypt a message for communication or email or anything like that. Now this circuit, just like other ciphers, means that adversaries cannot understand what the circuit is doing unless they have the secret key. And so we can encrypt hardware circuits just like we encrypt messages because of that low-level ones and zero description. Now the impact of cryptologic in the long term means that companies like Apple and Broadcom and even the DoD and other government agencies can fabricate chips with third parties and not worry about the intellectual property being at risk. We are encrypting hardware. Software can be encrypted, has been done for years and years, and this is the first ever approach to actually encrypt hardware with the same guarantees that we have with everyday ciphers.